That's amazing. I mean, it's just amazing.
He's still a farmer, hostage to the elements, pessimistic even in a wet season, but George Shaw still can't help but appreciate this crop for its unique beauty.
This might be the prettiest dirt road in Oklahoma right now, I'm thinking.
I think you're right.
A searcher might find purple prairie clover growing by itself in the pastures of Harper County, but Farmer Shaw figured out how to make it a carpet.
One plant, they come up from the crown every year, and they'll shoot out from the crown, and each one, depending on the rainfall, will produce, it'll have little runners come out. Out here where they say there's nothing, there's everything.
George isn't the only creature who likes this stuff. Bees and butterflies flock to it. Horny toads and jackrabbits like it for cover.
It's helping nature is the biggest deal.
Sometime in mid-July, after the blooms drop off, Shaw will gather up the seed that normally drops to the ground, and he'll sell it. The prettiest cash crop you'll ever see.
A lot of people, they'll want to put it in their flower gardens at their house or for different mixes for butterflies.
Shaw had to convince his dad to let him plant a little 7-acre plot 20 years ago. These days he grows clover, echinacea, Illinois bundle flower, and blue stem on the family farm.
My great-grandfather farmed this field here, this and another field over here with a team of mules.
He has 20 acres here, a bright purple spot in the middle of green and brown. A secluded space, but this season, as pretty a spot as you could find anywhere.
Really good crop. Haven't seen it look this good since 07.
Just ask the farmer, who's just about rolling in clover every time he looks. Near Buffalo, Oklahoma, Galen Culver, News 4. Is this a great state or what?
And Mr. Shaw says most of his prairie clover seeds go into packets for other gardeners.
Especially the ones trying to get pollinators like butterflies and bees to visit.